No, this should have been Bianca's win. I mean, God, enough with the Becky thing. Becky looks frail. Like, that's the nicest way to say it.
You she think?
Looks frail. Yeah. Oh, dude. At one point, who did she start? She started out with Naomi. When Naomi went to give her an arm drag, Becky took the arm drag like Harley Race in the early 90s. I'm like, honey, you're not, you're like, it's the weirdest thing. She's like wooden, but also incredibly skinny and frail. Like, I'm like, I love Becky, but what the fuck? Not good. Not good.
What is, why do you think she's losing so much weight? I mean, there has to have been people in the back that have said, hey, Becky, you ever think about, you know, going to the gym?
Like fat broads. I'm sorry, what?
But I'm serious. It's like, it's so weird because she used to have a real good physique. I mean, she's always been a thinner physique, but she had sinew to her. She had definition.
She was in shape. Right. Physique. There's thin in shape. And then there's just thin because you don't eat anything.
I know.
Work out for that matter.
Like, don't you think if you saw her fucking ribs and chest right now, they would just be poking out of her skin?
Her face looks drawn.
Oh, she's so gaunt.
Never have water.
Yeah.
Yeah. Super gaunt. She looks like somebody that just got out of an internment camp. Like, was given like 3 maggots and a splinter a day to survive. I mean, this is like, she's like at a Hunger Games. She's probably hungry 24 hours a day.
This is it. Like, looking at her face, you would think she might have had the surgery where they suck all the fat out of your cheekbones. But then you look at the rest of her, and I'm like, which, by the way, like, we say this, and it's not because there are people who are just skinny. And you don't want to make fun of people who are just skinny the same way where it's like if somebody's just really heavy. And you're like, yeah, you know what I'll do? I'll mock them. That'll help. But it's the same exact thing where you're like, yeah, some people are just skinny. Becky was never that. She's just that now. It looks bad. Like, you just.
Yeah.
And like I said, it's not like it's helping her work at all either. She's still moving around. Like I said, it looks very uncomfortable. Her offense is like very slow and plodding. It's like she's regressed. And it sucks to see. It sucks to see. And the wrong person won this match. And I really don't care about seeing her versus Rhea because Rhea looks like she should be able to fucking rip her in half.
Well, here's the buzz that's going around, too, is that a lot of people think that Seth might lose at WrestleMania and Becky might lose at WrestleMania and both of them are going to take time off. Do you guys see that as kind of the future picture for both of them?
Only if it involves her having something to eat. That's the only thing. Like, if they take time off, so
a parting meal?
she was fighting like she was finally gonna be able to eat something at the end of that match. Like,
well, that's,
I'm sorry, I don't know what's going on there, but it just doesn't look, it doesn't look like a professional athlete. Well, it doesn't look like somebody who fights for a living.
Right.
John, you know this too. And I mean, me and you are both from a similar community of people where there's vegans there. Right. I was told that this was part of the weight loss was that she's a vegan. And a lot of the problem that people will have with being vegan is one of two things. They eat nothing or they eat like shit. Because
my vegan friends are fat as fuck, bro.
Like, yeah, because they eat
completely doughy and out of shit. Yeah,
because they're like French fries, fried dough, bread.
Yeah, fake this, fake that.
Yeah, so it's like ends up a process of that, or it's very little.
Look at that picture that Mojo threw up of old school Becky working out. Look at that fucking physique. Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, she looked like somebody who could kick your ass. That was part of her. When she's standing there with her arms open and a broken nose. And in a tank top that says SmackDown, she's got definition in those arms. She looks like a girl who wants to fight. Believable. This version of her is not believable. She looks like an actress playing a role like on Glow or something, like who doesn't really know what she's doing. And she's a great wrestler.
I get it, by the way. Like, she's probably 25 or 26 in that picture. We all know it's easier to be in better shape and put on muscle at 25 or 26. But there's also a point where it's not, it doesn't look good. It doesn't look healthy.
Right.
And I don't know. I hope she takes time off and takes care of herself. Because there was a period of time. Yeah, there was a period of time after she had the kid where she was posting pictures of herself in like the hospital and shit. Which
she's in shape.
Well, no, I mean like in the hospital, John. Like they were showing, like she's like, here I am at the hospital. And I'm like, are you okay? And it does.
Let me ask you guys a question. Yeah. Put her in a ring with Jade Cargill. That doesn't look like a wrestling match.
And that's the problem is like, I mean, when we were even looking at the match, we're thinking Bianca Belair. I think me and Joe both said Bianca Belair on Thursday because Bianca versus Ripley just seemed like, oh, there's two muscle mommies beating the shit out of each other in the middle of WrestleMania. It makes sense.
Yeah. The two biggest female stars of the past year facing off at WrestleMania. Like, doesn't
that what it's supposed to be.
Connect the dots, really? I don't know. But
But people were very, by the way, you had to be careful. People, I noticed yesterday after we recorded, anybody who said that Becky shouldn't have won was attacked brutally by the internet wrestling community. And anybody who said that Becky doesn't look good was attacked brutally. It's like, I don't understand. Like, I'm supposed to forget what she looked like before, like when she was in
better You're not shape supposed to body shame in 2024, John.
Where's the shame that she's thinner than other people? That's right. A shameful thing.
I think it's shameful that she had a physique that looked like a killer once upon a time, and now she doesn't. I mean, if you ask me, could you imagine any other athlete in any other sport doing that? Like if you took a Michael Jordan and then all of a sudden shaved 100 pounds off of him and then said, hey, Michael Jordan, why don't you eat a sandwich? And then how dare you make fun of the Michael? How dare you make fun of him? And it's like,
yeah, remember when Paul Orndorff had the baby arm, how fucked up that looked? And people are like, what happened to Paul Orndorff's arm? Nobody was going.
Business. We notice when you don't look the same. I'm sorry. You're wrestling right in your underwear. Like you're not in a 3-piece suit or a suit of armor. That's part of the gig is your physique. That's part of the fucking gig. I mean, like what?
Tiffany God.
Looks like she works at 16 hours a day. Just got the big fake titties. Right? Looks like this is somebody who's doing this for a living.
Let me read these responses off for you, John. You like these about Becky from Tro, or not from Tro. Sorry, Tro posted it. I don't want to throw them on her. Yeah. Valupatita says it's karma because her daughter is sick. While she flew to Perth to steal other women's WrestleMania spot, nobody asked for that orange-haired, boob-sagging hag to insert herself into a WrestleMania match again. Like, she's so boring, and I'm glad her daughter is sick because it's karma for her stealing other people's WrestleMania opportunity year after year.
These are just mentally ill.
Oh, of course, but this is the kind of shit you'll see. And it's like, yeah, those people are the ones that need to be blasted, not the people going, hey, did you notice that she doesn't have muscle definition anymore?
Right, those get put in the same basket where it's just
because it's anything against the narrative of she's amazing and a lady boss and Arfadja. Like she's the least intimidating looking woman on the roster next to Liv. These are the two least intimidating looking women. Who would not? Like, you're supposed to have some kind of aura to you, dude. Charlotte's gonna come back looking like China, and
yeah, she is.
Like, mark my words, she's gonna come back looking like China year one.
No, you're right. It was one of those total like this match in general. And Raquel, by the way, I think Raquel, because they were talking about her skin condition or whatever, she's seemingly. God, this sounds like I'm saying it as an insult, but it's not. Where they're like, it looks like they stopped putting less makeup on her, probably because
she can't wear the makeup. That's
what right. And she still looked great. I'm not saying it like great. A bad thing, but you could tell that they stopped doing it as much.
No,
but,
yeah, I think, Raquel, dude, I'm not going to fucking dogpile on her, but if she's that bad where she can't work out, she can't build. I mean, first off, let's stop treating her like a muscle character if she can't work out anymore. And if she can't even put on makeup, maybe her disease needs to be taken seriously and she needs to be pulled off of TV until either she can get it under control or she can find an alternative, because it's not doing her any favors. Because we're just talking about what she looks like and what she can't do. How much is it actually hurting her physically just to even be out there? Because if her entire skin is on fire 24 hours a day, it's like even the lightest touch probably is awful for her.
Yeah.
Well, that's like having an autoimmune disease fucks your whole body up.
Yeah, no, of course. It's like, but then why would you put yourself in such a physical, I mean, I guess it's your job, but Jesus Christ, at what point does your own personal health take over your job, right? And WWE is a different company now anyways. They're not going to be like, oh, well, you're fired, bitch. They're going to let her go, get treatment, get rehab, give her the fucking Roman Reigns thing. She takes off for a little while. She goes and gets healthy, comes back for a match here and there, see how it works, and then disappears for a while. Maybe WrestleMania, she does disappear after that. I don't know.
And then you come back, you get pinned by Liv Morgan. Clean.
Right. Yeah, perfect. Right. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. No, I mean, I still like Raquel. I still cheer for her.
I like Raquel.
Yeah,
I do too. I just don't like that she's clearly not at her best. And we're supposed to believe that everything is fine when this girl can't even put on eyeliner without screaming. So
Jesus Christ.
Becky still ultimately, she's your winner, but she, out of all of the women in this, well, I can't say next to Liv, but
yeah,
she Liv certainly didn't look like the person that should win this match. Tiffany looks like a fucking beast. Bianca's a fucking jacked monster who's awesome. And Raquel is at least large.
Yeah.
Naomi is still, I mean, Naomi's solid. She's just a solid fucking wrestler. And she obviously looks strong, and Becky doesn't.
So,
right.
I don't know.
Follow WrestleSoup on Twitter at WrestlingSoup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.